Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there. Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope. For who could ever learn to love a beast?
Thank you. Except one uncle who will make it, but that happens. and my point of view is somewhat misty-eyed. There's nothing clearer in my life than what I wish had been for you. And that's a lot, no matter what.
Not one word in the air, not one word! Please, I don't mean to intrude, but I lost my way in the woods, and I need a place to stay for the night.
Poor meadow, Conqueror Hallahard. Monsieur, you are welcome here.
I heard that. I know there's someone here, and I'll lend you to step out where I can see you.
Hello!
Ah! And goodbye!
Wait, but you're a clock, and you're toffee.
Astonishing, isn't it? And quite inexplicable. Goodbye.
I beg your pardon. I don't mean to be rude, but it's just that, well, I've never seen it. A tar.
Bless you.
Monsieur, you are chilled to the bone. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
No, I forbid it. You mean it is. Head in the house, tell the manager to stop right there.
Oh, not the master's chair. I'm not seeing this.
Just being married. Don't tell me a little thing like that's going to change your feelings for me.
Oh, no!
No, never!
And we'll still have our little red day's booze, won't we?
Oh, yes!
Yes!
Always!
Good. Well, if we're going to have a wedding, I guess I'd better propose to the bride. For you, mademoiselle.
A miniature portrait of you. You shouldn't have.
Don't mention it. You know, Belle, there isn't a girl in town who wouldn't love to be in your shoes. This is the day your dreams come true.
What can you possibly know about my dreams, Gaston?
Have you seen Gaston?
You just missed him. Wait a minute. Where did you get this scarf?
This? In the woods. Pretty nice, huh?
This belongs to my father.
Yeah, well, father's keepers.
LeFou, I want you to think hard and tell me exactly where you found that.
No!
Think!
Somewhere in the woods.
Harder.
Near the crossroads, okay? Ow!
But he's still out there somewhere. LeFou, you have to take me back.
Not the woods again.
But don't you see? Something must have happened to him. Oh, LeFou, you have to take me back.
Not on your life.
Then I'll fight it myself.
She always was too vain about her looks, and that's exactly what she's become.
A vanity.
To draw spirit of the works.
And poor Jean-Claude.
Who?
Jean-Claude, you remember him, not too bright, that is
a... A brick?
The whole wall.
Jean-Claude's a brick wall?
That's it in the kitchen behind the stove. And beyond the house, boy?
Mealy-mouthed little bootlet. I never liked him. He's always grumbling at the master's feet.
A doormat.
Here.
It's happening faster with some of the others, but we are not far behind. Slowly but surely, as every day passes, we will all gradually become things.
But why did we have to get dragged into this whole spell business? It's not like we threw that poor old beggar woman out on her ear.
No, but are we not responsible, too, for helping to make him the way that he is?
I suppose so.
All I know is that I will eventually melt away to nothing. I only hope there's something left in me if the master's ever to break the spell.
Hold on, old man. We've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anyone home? Hello?
It's a girl.
Yes, of course. I can see it's a girl.
It's a girl! Mademoiselle!
Now, do we get it? We go on the top.
It's there. I know someone.
nothing you can do.
Please, I'll do anything.
I said there is nothing you can do.
Take me instead.
No.
What did you say?
Take me instead.
Beth, I won't let you do this.
You would do that? You would take his place?
If I did.
This is where I should learn to be happy.
Nothing like a nice warm cup of tea to make the world seem a bit brighter.
But you're a
Mrs. Potts, dear. Please to make your acquaintance.
Careful, darling.
Who are you?
Madame de la Grande Bouche. Perhaps you've heard of me.
Sorry.
You see? They've forgotten all about me. One can be, and I quote, the test of Europe, the brightest star of it to grace the stage. But fall into what spell and
Wait! This is impossible.
I know it is, but here we are. Well now, what shall we dress you in for dinner? This is nice, but how would you like to borrow one of my gowns? Let's see what I've got in my drawers.
What?
come down to dinner.
I'm hungry.
I am the master of this castle, and I'm telling you to come down to dinner.
And I'm telling you, I'm not hungry.
You're hungry if I say you're hungry.
Don't be ridiculous.
What?
You can't go around ordering people to be hungry. It doesn't work like that.
I can...
Besides, it's rude.
Oh, rude, is it? Well, how about this? If you don't come down to dinner, I will drag you by the hair!
That may not be the best way to win the girl's affection.
Please, attempt to be a gentleman.
But why is she being so difficult? Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come down to dinner. I'll give her one last chance. Would you be so kind as to join me for dinner? Please!
No, thank you.
Master, please!
If she doesn't eat with me, she doesn't eat at all!
What are we thinking? We'll never be human again!
So it appears.
Well, what would you have us do? Give up? I can't give up until I hear the sound of my boy's laughter as he runs through these halls again.
Quite right, Mrs. Potts. We mustn't give up, rather. Still a chance. Come here. I want you to stand guard at this door, and if there's the slightest change, inform me at once.
We won't, can we talk?
I ask nicely, but she refuses. What does she want me to do?
Babe?
Show me the door.
In my hands, in this, you do not love me anymore. This horrible
can eat anything at all.
Well, I am a little hungry.
Except that.
Cosworth!
Well, you heard what the master said.
Pish tosh! I'm not about to let the poor child go hungry.
Fine. Glass of water, crust of bread,
Cosworth, I'm surprised at you.
She's not a
prisoner. She's our guest. We must make her feel welcome here.
All right, dinner. But keep it down. If the master finds out, be our next.
Of course, of course. But what is dinner without a little music?
Music?
Oh, cher mademoiselle, it is the deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you here tonight. And now we invite you to relax. Let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly presents your dinner. Our guest, be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie a napkin around your neck, Sherry, and we'll try the rest. So if you have to dare, why we only live to serve, try the gray stuff.
It's delicious.
Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, if this is stress, and the dinner here will never second best. Go on and pull your menu, take a glass, and when you'll be our guest. Be our guest, be our guest. Be brand new, cheesy, I'm pulling all from me. Prepare us, Larry, good day, cabaret. You're alone and you're safe. The face is over there. No one's gloomy or complaining while the flat is entertained.
Oh.
and painted ceilings, complete with sheriffs. Frog given tonight amidst the nymphs and centaurs.
Act like a gentleman. This will be good. Oh, Belle! Belle?
Now, if you will note the unusual inverted archways, as you can see, this is yet another example of the late neoclassic Baroque period, and as I always say, if it's not Baroque, then don't fix it!
Act like a gentleman, and nothing but a fool.
And thanks to some quick thinking on my part, the disaster was averted, and that was the last time a stone of that weight was quarried in this area.
What's up here?
Nothing at all. Any interest in the West Wing?
Oh, so that's the West Wing.
Nice going!
I wonder what he's hiding up there.
Hiding? What an idea, hiding. Perhaps Mademoiselle would like to see something else. We have exquisite tapestry dating all the way back to Aloysius the Pretentious.
Maybe later.
Perhaps you'd like to see the garden! Or the library!
You have a library?
With books!
So yes, scads of books, mountains of books, forests of books, cascades, flowers, swamps of books!
Books with pictures! Books with words!
Lesson could teach me how I
I could have been.